Welcome to this lecture where we will try to test our whole project. So I'm on my blog.php, so we will try the basic testing from the public view. So going down, you can see I applied the link on the admin name. So if I click on the admin name here, I'm on the page of profile.php and I can fetch the information about that particular admin. So if I give it some wrong admin name, I'm being redirected to the page of blog.php with a session message of bad request. So that's working completely fine. Then you can see we have this category world. So I will apply the link on this category so that we can fetch all the posts which have this category when the user will click on this category. So in order to apply a link here back to my editor, this is the file of blog.php. So if I go down to the place where we are showing that category in our page, you can see on line 126 we have this category. So right before this category name, I will add one anchor tag here. And first let's wrap up all of this with the anchor. Then here I will apply a link. So go to the page of blog.php and with the search query parameter will be category equal to, then I can copy this whole PHP and I can put it here. So the search query parameter will be the category name which we are showing next right here. So that would be it. If I save this one and refresh my page, you can see world got this link. If I click world, I'm on the page of blog.php, category is equal to world. And here are all the posts with this category. So if I go back and select another category from here, for example, if I select this news, click on this post 14, category news. So these are all the posts with the category of news. And I can also navigate from one of this panel, so click fitness, category is equal to fitness, all the category with fitness post. So if I click on read more button, you can see I'm on the page of fullpost.php and we don't have the link here. So the same line I can copy from blog.php file and I can paste that in my other file of fullpost. So copying this whole small from a blog.php file, let's close all of these files. Now opening my fullpost.php file, going to the area where we are showing that information of small tag. So it's right here. I will apply this one here. So saving this one. Now if I refresh my page, you can see we got the link here. So if I click fitness, all the posts on blog page with the fitness category. If I click Xerox one-to-one, this is the profile page. So on this fullpost.php, if I remove this 23 and add something like negative here, we are on the page of fullpost.php and ID is equal to minus 45. So it's still showing us this comment section. So if I give it some comment like this, submit, something went wrong, try again. So if I remove this whole 45 from here, enter, you can see we are still having this comment section. So if I remove all of this from here, then I redirect it to the page of blog.php. So we have to make sure when this ID is not the right one, we should not show this form here. So this file of fullpost.php, at the place where we are showing our data. So I'm showing my data here, SQL. If select all the posts from my table where ID is this post ID from URL. And here you can see I applied this condition that if the post ID from URL is not set, then send to the page of blog.php. So right after this query, I can use my function of SQL, that is row count. So adding that function here, so using the stmt object, and calling the function of row count, and this will be equal to our result variable. Then on the next line I can say that if this result variable is not equal to 1, then have this error message and send the user to the page of blog.php, page is equal to 1. So let's try this one. I just added this row count. If the row count is not equal to 1, then you should have this error message. So if I save this one, this is the full post.php file. So if I refresh my page, you can see bad request now. Let's try it again. So read more, removing this 32 and making it to 9. Bad request. Clicking again, removing all of this from here. Bad request. So make sure that you do all of this testing on the public page so that you don't have to cry later. And this one is working completely fine. Then we have recent post. If I click post 17, I'm on the page of fullpost.php, and this is my full post. I can add the comment on this one. So adding a comment here. Submit. Our comment submitted successfully, and I'm still on that page. So now let's check out our admin panel, but we still have this search here. So if I search for something like insect go, you can see this post which I just fetch with this search query button. So if I remove from here the search button, see we are on the page of blog.php and there is no error at all here. And this is completely fine view of public. Let's go to our main admin page. So opening my file of dashboard.php. First of all, let's log out. And then I will try to go into my page of posts. Login required, giving some name of Zoe 333. Giving wrong password, login. So giving Xerox 121, giving password 1234, login. So welcome Zilu here. And you can see this post 17 has one pending comment here. And if I click on this approve comment, you can see I have to approve this comment. So if I approve, that comment is appearing right here. If I disapprove, that will be here. I can also delete this comment. So let's delete this one. Or that's working completely fine. If I click on posts, I can edit any post, I can delete any post. So lastly, on this dashboard page, let's add one new post. So this post title will be testing lastly, and giving it some category of news, selecting some image, this one. And for the post content, I will go with, this is a great post. Pasting some text here. So click publish. Post edit successfully. Going to the post page, you can see this new post here. If I click on live preview, you will see this full post. But most of the times you will not have just one text. You might have couple of images inside your post. You might have some HTML or CSS associated with your post. So how you can do that? So in order to do that, you have to add the straight HTML inside the post content. So you can see I have this whole post here. So if I want to add one h1 heading, so I can add h1 here in a simple straight HTML format. Then let's add HR tag. Then after some text, I will add this div with some height and some background color. And then if I want to add some image here, for example, I want to add this image that is saved inside my images directory, and its name is avatar.png. Let's also give it some width and height. So width will be 300 and height will be 200. So I'm adding straight HTML here. Now closing of this image tag. So now if I publish this post, you can see post updated successfully. So if I click on this live preview, you can see this whole post, and it's not taking this HTML as a straight one. It's treating my HTML as a simple straight text. So in order to make this page to treat these tags as an HTML, you have to apply one function. So I'm gonna go to my page of fullpost.php. So opening that post page, it's right here. The area where we are showing the description of our post. So you can see we have this post description area right here. So I applied the function of HTML entities, and I said many times this function is going to help you not to break your HTML structure. So in case if you want to break your HTML structure and if you want to see the tags in a format, you have to add another function, that is nl2br. So if I save this function, so this function will try to find the HTML tags and CSS and convert them in the respective styles. So if I save this one and if I just refresh this page, see, now we have all the stylish content. I can add another image here. For example, if I go back to this post edit, so this was our H1, HR. I can copy this whole div again and I can put it here. I can make this image here. Right after this style, I can have unordered list here that will have some list items. So if I click publish, my post updated successfully. Click on the live preview. This is my post which have the list item now. So you can also add the style to these list items in your file of styles.css, this file, and your HTML is going to pick those style from this file. So this is how you can add the style to your post. There are many third-party plugins available which can help you to have more sophisticated form in order to create your post. By that, you can add the H1 heading, H3 heading directly on your page. To summarize all of this, if you want to show the styles to your HTML, just add this function of nl2br. One more thing I want to show you here. I added a couple of new posts on my blog, and if I go to my read more button, you can see I'm on my page of fullpost.php, and this is my full post. So on these two pages, blog.php and fullpost.php, we have this similar design in the right side. So if you want to write the lesser code, you can put all of this left area code in another file, and you can include that file on both of blog page and also on the full post page. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm gonna open my file of blog.php. So here is this file, blog.php. Now I'm going to my side area, where the side area is starting. You can see our side area is starting from line 185. So I'm gonna cut everything from here. For a moment, I cut everything from here and I will create another file with the name of footer.php. Now inside this file, I will put the whole side area including all the ending of our body and HTML tag. Now I will save this file. Now also let me save this blog.php file. So first of all, let's bring our blog.php. I'm gonna refresh my page. You can see now I have nothing here in the side area. So now if I include that footer file that has the ending of our body and HTML tags. So I will add this file in a PHP scope. So require once this file of footer.php. So if I save this page and refresh my page of blog.php, see, now we got our right side area here. So same like this, I can do the same thing for my other page of fullpost.php. So opening that page, full post, let's go to our side area. So our side area is starting from line 233. I'm gonna cut everything from here. So first of all, let's save this file fullpost.php and let's bring this full post page. So this is my full post. You can see we don't have any right side area, and also there is no footer here because I cut everything from this file. So now I can include that file here. So including my file of footer.php. So if I save this file of fullpost.php and just refresh this page, see, now we got our right side area and also our footer. So this is a great approach in order to minimize the code in your main files. And this code organization is so much important when you have a larger file and you want to manage the content in more logical way. So apply this technique if you want to put the lesser code in your main files, but I will give you the whole project code in the form of full code. So let's revert these changing that we did in our full post page and also on our blog.php. So pressing Ctrl Z. Saving this full post page with all the code. And let's put this require once in a comment so that when you have the coding exercises and at the end of completing this course, you can make this file in a more organized way. So I'm gonna save this file fullpost.php. Let's also do the same thing for blog.php. So first of all, let's press Ctrl Z to revert everything back to its original position. So this is our blog.php with everything, and right at the end, I'm gonna require this footer.php file and let's comment this for now. So let's refresh our page of full post and also our page of blog. So we have everything in the older format. So you can apply this code organization to have the lesser code in your main area.